Good morning, children. How are you all? So, children, in previous video, we learned about the pasta story and more about the pasta. Okay. So today we are going to start a new chapter of general knowledge. Okay. So, children, you can guess the name of the chapter. What should be the name? You can guess the name now. See the pictures. Anyone? Yes. So the name of the chapter is traffic signs. Yes. So children, what is the meaning of traffic signs? With the help of the traffic signs, we know that what is the meaning of these signs, and we have to follow the rules, correct? It means in this chapter we are going to learn the different type of signs, and we can also going to learn the meaning of each and every sign. So after the learning of this chapter, what you have to do after the understanding the traffic signs and learning about it, you have to follow all the traffic rule. Okay, children? Yes. So now I'm going to start the chapter. So children, this is our third chapter. We are not going to learn the second chapter, that is the quiz time, because we skip this chapter for now. Okay, so everyone move to the chapter number 3, that is traffic sign, and open your page number 243 in your Fusion Sem 2 textbook. Okay, now everyone come to the exercise of this chapter. Okay, so before starting the chapter, firstly we have to need to understand about the traffic sign. Okay, so everyone, let's start and learn more about the traffic sign. Okay, so children, have you seen all these boards and signals? So in this chapter we are going to learn the meaning of each symbol. Okay, so here we give you all are, have you seen all these lights? Have you seen all these lights on the road, that is red, yellow and green? So children, what is the meaning of red light? Red light means that you have to stop your vehicle. Okay, after the red light we also see the green light. What is the meaning of green light? It means you have to go. Okay, after the green light there is a one more light which we called it as a yellow light. Yellow light means you have to slow down your vehicle and stop it before the signal. Okay children, so these are the three lights. Now these are some signs which we called as a road symbol. So what is the meaning of road symbol? Let's understand the meaning. So children, there is a one board, round board, in which P is written. What is the meaning of this symbol? It means parking symbol. It means here you have to park your vehicle. Okay, now the next symbol is the stop symbol. What is the meaning of a stop symbol? It means here you have to stop. Okay, now the next symbol is known as a give way symbol on the road. See, so it is a meaning of that we have to give way. This symbol is found on which road, which one is the very busiest road. Okay, so it means give the way. Okay, now the next symbol is a round symbol in which numbers are written. Suppose here it is written 50 kilometer, so this symbol is known as sign for speed limit. If it is written as 50 kilometer, so it meaning that the speed limit is 50 kilometer per hour. It means we should drive our vehicle at a speed of 50 kilometers per hour. Correct. Now the next symbol is called as a school ahead symbol. So what is the meaning of a school ahead symbol? So children, it means that it gives the drivers advance warning of an upcoming school, so they can slow down and know to watch for children crossing. Okay, now the next symbol. So here what the driver have to do, driver needs to drive slowly. Okay, now the next one is a one symbol in which P is written and crossing. So meaning of it means no, we called it as a no parking symbol. So what is the meaning of that? That you are not allowed to park your vehicle here. Now next one is the pedestrian symbol. Children, actually we called it as a zebra lines, the white strips you can see on the road. These white strips are known as the zebra line. So what is the use of the zebra line? It means this signs cautions the driver to either slow down or stop the vehicle and allow the pedestrians to cross the roads. It cautions for driver that they have to slow or stop your vehicle. So that's why the pedestrian can easily cross the road. Okay, children. So this is the meaning of zebra crossing. Okay, now next one is the parking this side symbol. It means you show the direction, in which direction you have to park your vehicle. Now children, some more boards are given for the directions, whether you have to move east, west, south or north. It's only for the direction. Okay. About east, west, north, south, it's explain about the direction. Now some more symbols for left, right, up and down. So children, these are the some symbols which we use for explain for the following, for the rule, traffic signs, for everything. Now everyone come to your exercise. Okay, so everyone open your page number 243 in your Fusion Sem2 textbook. Okay, children, what you have to do here, see in this chapter 3, that is a traffic sign. What you have to do here, identify the traffic sign in the picture and write your names in the blanks. You can also use the help box. So in the down of the page, see help box is given. So from this help box, we have to choose the correct option. Okay. And according to the signs. Okay. So here some numbers are given. So children, see the first number. What it indicates, which traffic sign it indicates. You can see there is a triangle, there is a triangle and in which the picture of two children are given. So what this sign indicates? Yes, it indicates caution school ahead. Okay, so everyone write it, caution school ahead. Now come to the second symbol. What it indicates? See, you can see here one train now and it also show the railway path. See here we have the railway path. So what it indicates? It indicates that there is a railway crossing. It indicates that in now on the road we have the railway crossing. It means you have to pay your attention and then cross the road. Okay, so this symbol is known as railway crossing. Now come to the question number 3. So there you can see the white strips on the road. So what we called these strips? We called it as a, yes, zebra crossing. And this is for pedestrians. That's why they can easily cross the road. Yes. Now come to the fourth symbol. What you see, children? This strip. Well, you can see this sign. It is a alphabet U, just like U, na. So we called it as U-turn. What is the meaning of this symbol? It means from here you have to turn. You take the U-turn. You are not allowed to go further. Yes. So from this you have to take the U-turn. Yes, you are not allowed to go further. So that's why we called it as a U-turn. Now come to the question number 5. You see the sign here. What is, what you can see? See, there is a one horn and on with there is a cross. So what is the meaning of that symbol? We called it as a no horn symbol. What is the meaning of no horn signs? Means here you are not allowed to give horn from your vehicle. Okay, so that's why we called it as a no horn symbol. Now come to the sixth symbol. What is the meaning? What is it indicate? You can see on the symbol P is written, on which there is a one cross. So we called it as a no parking symbol. Correct. It means here you are not allowed to park your vehicle. Okay, so children, in this chapter we'll learn about the traffic signs. So everyone, what is the assignment for you? The assignment is that you have to complete your exercise with the help of the given PDF and with the help of explanation. Okay, so everyone, complete your chapter third, that is traffic sign, and try to memorize it. Okay, so till then, everyone, stay safe, stay healthy, and bye-bye.